Hej och välkommen till The Norden. I den här serien granskar vi den omtalade nordiska välfärden bara att vi gör det genom en utomstående, neutral, icke-nordisk besökares ögon. Frågan är hurudant samhälle vi nordbor egentligen sist och slutligen har byggt upp. I det här avsnittet ska Peter Whittingham, till vardags polis i Los Angeles, USA, få se hur den nordiska polisen jobbar. Och bland annat lära sig att de norska kollegorna, ja, de jobbar obeväpnade.
You call them a customer?
We call them a customer, yes. We are, that's what we do.
It was difficult for me to wrap my mind around as a police officer.
Of course it is, yes.
The last time we fired our gun, I know it was last Friday.
USA och de nordiska länderna har i proportion ungefär lika stor poliskår. Och till stora delar rätt liknande brottslighet också. Vi talar stöld, skadegörelse, fortkörning, fylla, familjevåld, narkotika, för att nu nämna de vanligaste. En stor signifikant skillnad finns det i varje fall, nämligen det här med vapenhanteringen. För bara under de första månaderna av till exempel 2012 avfyrade polisen i Los Angeles fler skott i tjänst än samtliga nordiska poliskårer tillsammans under hela året. Var det för att de verkligen måste göra det eller för att det nu helt enkelt bara blev så? Och hur ställer sig polisen här till sina maktbefogenheter? Vi har bjudit in en polis från nämnda Los Angeles Police Department hit till Norden för att diskutera polisiära likheter och framförallt skillnader.
I'm Peter Whittingham. I'm a police officer, police captain with the police department in Los Angeles. I have been in this business of law enforcement since 1974. I joined the Jamaica Police Department as a young man in 1974. And then I migrated to the United States in late 83. You just never know when somebody is out there trying to not only prevent you from serving, but prevent you from going home to your family. That's the life of a Los Angeles police officer. I only point my weapon at someone when I am endangered. It's very easy to say that, you know, it's us against them. When you think that you're fighting for your life.
Resan börjar i Vasa. En stad på ungefär 60 000 invånare. Peter, han får besöka det stökigaste området i stan. Och vår gäst reagerar genast på den finländska kollegans ordval.
Our customers, we put them here.
Really?
Yes. And
you call them a customer?
We call them a customer, yes. That's what we do.
Okay, we call them suspect.
Yes.
Dags att gå igenom utrustningen.
Tasers. Okay, that's similar to what we have. And you have
spray.
Okay, that's OC spray and
ASP.
Yes, we do carry that as well. And how many handcuffs do you carry?
Two
handcuffs. Okay, that's similar to our. And this is your standard uniform.
Yes, standard uniform, and under uniform we all have naturally the bulletproof vest. Allowed our setter.
But how often do you have a shooting?
In Finland, if we think about the whole country in Finland, so should I say less than 5 times each year in whole Finland?
Have you ever had a shooting here in Vasa?
No. Or we have had, but it's maybe for 10, 20 years ago.
Really? I've had a lot of situations to have drawn my weapon. I have used a weapon since 1974. I'm very, very familiar with
with my weapon.
Och nu ska vi göra ett litet praktiskt test. Lasse, som sitter i bilen här, har just bränt förbi rött ljus i korsningen och polisen har följaktligen stannat honom. Hur skulle du själv uppleva att bli stannad på äkta LAPD-vis?
Keep your hands on the steering wheel.
Vi ska återkomma till det om en alldeles liten stund. Men nu ska vi fundera på vem som egentligen väljer yrket polis. I Umeå träffar vi Manda.
Jag heter Manda, är 23 år gammal och går här på polisutbildningen i Umeå. Amerikanska polisen. Ja, det är ju det man ser i tv på filmer. De är lite mer offensiva framåt. Och så sen är de här serierna som springer runt med högklackat och allt. Welcome.
Vid polisakademin i Los Angeles räcker polisutbildningen 6 månader.
How long you been here at the academy?
4 terms. So it's 2 years now.
2 years?
Yes.
And I thought 6 months was a long time.
Yeah.
So it's about 17.
Inne på polisutbildningen i Umeå blir Peter lite förvånad över den avslappnade approachen i korridorerna.
In the Los Angeles Police Academy, it is expected on day one, as you report for duty in your suit and tie, that you see yourself as now in a changed environment. You're now a Los Angeles Police recruit in training. I was looking in the classroom and there was a group of students in the classroom, and they were dressed in ordinary everyday clothes and tank tops.
Genom ett av fönstren ser han till och med skägg.
There are even students with beards.
Is that not common in
No,
LA?
Not at all. No.
Can you have a beard?
No.
No, it's like in the military here in Sweden.
Yeah. In LA you have to be clean shaven every day.
Every day.
Yes. The casualness of the environment did not give the impression to what I'm used to in terms of police academy.
På skjutbanan blir det däremot allvar.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. It's like this.
Harder. You're hitting like a girl.
Oh my god. All right. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Okay, good. That's it. That's how a cop hits. Okay, good.
And then
good,
you have
good,
to
good.
Back off.
What motivated you to become a police officer?
I have always liked people and I like working with people.
Okay.
And I think it's important with what's wrong and what's right, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's what I was telling earlier. That was my motivation as well.
What
month were you born? Let's talk about that.
What month? April.
Okay, so you're Aryan.
Yeah.
Is that it? Yeah, okay.
And you're?
Sagittarian. I was very impressed with Manda, and I could tell as she explained her value system and the reasons why she really want to be a police officer, that we have a good cop in the making.
Det har blivit fredag kväll. Folk ska ut och slå runt i staden Umeå.
We've been here now for maybe approximately 30 minutes, and the interesting thing is that I haven't seen one police officer. I haven't heard one siren on a Friday night in downtown. That's remarkable. You could tell that the people walking around were not looking over their shoulders in fear of somebody trying to rob them.
I couldn't find a police officer anywhere.
Well, we don't actually see much of the force at all in the smaller villages.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, we have them for, what is it, 1 hour on Mondays. That's how long we have.
Like that.
Really?
We used to have four cops stationed in our town, and two of them were on were off to another place to help those guys. The other two were on vacation. So we didn't have anything for 3 months or something.
So basically, we live in almost lawless town.
When was the last time you talked to a police officer?
Several years ago.
Have you seen police around?
Maybe one time, but...
So you don't see a lot of police around here?
No, but it's also safe, so it's not really needed here.
I like to see walking police officers, not just in the cars, you know.
Okay.
You see, but if you're walking, people could talk to him and then just discuss.
And you don't have a chance to talk to your police officers, do you?
That's quite sometimes, but they usually are in cars.
What do you think your police officers should focus on that would be of interest to you?
I'm not sure. They're doing a wonderful job, actually.
They are? Okay.
I'm not actually sure what they're doing, but they're doing a good job.
What kind of crime occurs around here?
Well, there was a murder here.
Thanks for talking to me.
No problem.
Okay, take care. Stay safe.
Tillbaka till bilkontrollen tidigare. Vi hade alltså en fiktiv situation där chauffören har kört mot rött och har blivit stannad av polis. Nu ska vi se hur finländsk kontra amerikansk polis tacklar situationen.
God kväll.
God kväll.
Märkte du vad hände där vid korsningen? 200 meter bakåt.
Det blinkade inte.
Nej, det var lite rött ljus.
Keep your hands on the steering wheel. Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
What was your reason for opening the door?
When I open the door, I can immediately see much more than from the window. And then if the situations change, I can use the door as a shield. If he, for example, decides to attack from the car. So I can use the door as a shield and take steps backward, and I can play time for myself.
Okay. In my case, the hands are my concern. Mm. And as long as I can see his hands, I don't care what he wants to do with his feet. Mm.
Yes. Yes. We noticed that when you came to the car, you touched the corner.
Actually the trunk. And not just touch it, but I press it down in the event that there was somebody in the trunk. So whoever is in there stays there.
Yes.
While I approach the door. That's just a normal tactic that we do. Do you do that?
No, we don't do that.
Okay. Anything out of the norm would alert you. Is it a case where there's an attempt to hide something? His head is not moving, but you can tell his shoulder's moving. Then you're going to do whatever you have to do to make sure that you're prepared for any sudden moves out of the ordinary.
Och under natten har han nåtts av tråkiga nyheter från jobbet där hemma.
One of my officers was involved in an OIS, officer-involved shooting. It's unfortunate, but the officer is okay, and that's an important thing.
Vi reser som bäst omkring i Norden tillsammans med Peter Whittingham. Till vardags jobbar han som polis i Los Angeles Police Department. Vi håller på och jämför polisutrustning mellan USA och Norden. Vi frågar oss varför amerikansk polis är så skjutbenägen. Och vi är för tillfället på väg till Mo i Rana i Norge. Som är speciellt på det viset att det landets poliskår är obeväpnad. Återstår att se hur Peter köper det.
Mu Irana is it's a picturesque city, especially in the winter. It's like a postcard city.
År 2013 avfyrade norsk polis summa ett varningsskott i luften och två skott mot person. Bara i Peter Whittinghams hemstad Los Angeles är siffrorna fullständigt annorlunda.
Jag heter Remi Anbak, jobbar i politiet i 2000. Jobbar till daglig som vaktledare, så är den som är ledare för styrken som är på. Vi har mycket narkotikakriminalitet, väldigt mycket. Och så är det det vanliga med våld, vinning, alltså inbrud och den biten. Norge skjuts det kanske ett skudd i året. I USA är det väl lite mer. Men de har då också en helt annan klientell att förhålla sig till.
Orsaken till de norska siffrorna är förstås att polisen där är obeväpnad. Nu ska vi se hur Peter reagerar på den informationen.
What kind of equipment do you carry in your belt?
Handcuffs, the pepper spray.
Okay.
Baton. Yeah. Radio.
Mm-hmm.
And
What caliber weapon do you carry?
Not on the body.
Not on the body.
We don't carry guns.
No. Really?
No. We don't. We have it in a locker in the car.
In a locker.
Yeah.
The officer said that the last time somebody fired a gun here was 5 years ago. You know, the last time we fired our gun, I know it was last Friday. I don't understand the rationale for any police department that tells me that I am to be deployed in the field, not knowing what to expect. And I have to keep my gun locked up in the car, in a locker. Doesn't make sense. What about cities like Oslo?
Yeah.
Do the officers there, same thing, are not allowed to carry guns?
Yeah, no one in Norway carrying guns.
Really?
No. Everyone mm-hmm. has to ask. Also, we bring it in the cars, and mm-hmm. if something happens, if it's urgent, and I just take it out, but I have to call and say I took out the guns. But
in a big city like that, it is more likely that you will have more.
They bring out their weapons every day.
Yes.
So someone said that we are the world's most not armed police.
Okay.
Men vad innebär det här alltså i praktiken? En polis går beväpnad, en annan går obeväpnad. Vi tar och ställer oss på torget i Mo i Rana och så föreställer vi oss att en man just har rånat en av affärerna. Han har sprungit iväg och nu står han och skriker och viftar med någonting som ser ut som ett vapen. Hur skulle våra två poliser här agera om de råkar patrullera förbi?
Well, I would get behind cover and give directions from behind cover. Maybe there, where I could clearly see the suspect. If the person is armed, the suspect is armed with a weapon, that would threaten the life of the victim, or my life is in danger. In defense of my life, I will discharge my weapon.
Och hur skulle obeväpnade Remi tackla läget?
If you know or somebody have seen a knife or a gun, then we will bring the guns. But we will use every options to not use the gun.
So we have a different force option.
Yes.
Depend on the level of force, and it can escalate certainly from a verbalization to a pepper spray.
Yeah.
Then we may go to the level of a taser.
Yeah.
Then we may deploy a beanbag.
Yeah.
And with those options available, we're able to minimize lethal force.
I think the local police in the last maybe 15 years, mm-hmm. have maybe fired one round.
Okay.
And that's warning shots. Oh. Yeah.
No, vad tycker allmänheten då om att lagens långa arm måste först ringa chefen förrän han eller hon får beväpna sig?
Sometimes I think they should be armed.
Yeah.
Because there's many people with guns and knives.
Okay.
Well, I think it's okay. They have their guns in the cars, I think.
But do you think it's a concern if they are confronted with somebody with a gun and they have to go back to their car to retrieve their weapon?
Of course, that's not convenient, is it?
Especially if you are the one who yeah. is targeted.
They can't not do anything if the criminal have the gun.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, police will stay, what? Don't shoot me.
I think it's the right way for me, uh-huh. because sometimes if you just have to come on with your weapon, it's like pushing the person to act immediately.
Okay.
So I think their own way is like to just behave like there is nothing that's going to happen, uh-huh. and then when you try to react, then they also react.
Tillbaka i Mo i Ranas polisstation berättar Remi om säkerhetsarrangemangen i själva byggnaden.
The glass is bulletproof. Also at the windows in the room, you see the officers, they work in the room.
There's a bulletproof?
Yes.
Yes?
And there is the wall below the window is made of steel and steel inside.
But how do you rationalize the security measure that you take to secure the station at the same time deprive you of the ability to immediately arm yourself to respond to a life-threatening situation?
That's a tough one. It is. And I think it's not logical. It is not. Not for me.
Yeah.
But that's maybe politician, maybe it's Norwegian, I don't know.
The officer said that one of their own got killed because he went to a knife fight with his bare hands. You deprive them of the ability to effectively respond to those situations. I don't understand, and I suspect from the conversation I had with that officer that he agrees. He indicated that that there's a split in the police department. That some 51% is in favor of carrying a firearm, and another 49, the 49ers as we call them, are reluctant to.
LAPD-polisen Peter Whittinghams resa i Norden är slut. Och vi frågar honom om hans bild av de nordiska poliskollegorna.
And going back to Vasa and the other cities we have been, I don't get the sense that anybody is seriously concerned about their safety. That is good. The concern, however, though, is the extent to which law enforcement officers may take that for granted and become so complacent that since there are no serious crime here, I need not be prepared. The unfortunate thing about that is it puts you in a situation where you're always learning from 2020 hindsight. The culture of law enforcement here is that it's not going to happen here.